Hi, my name is Sarah, and welcome to my channel. Today, I'm very excited to be doing a bookshelf tour. So, I recently moved and bought all these new bookshelves. So I'll try to find a picture of my bookshelves before. I meant to take a picture of them before I took them all down, but I was just too excited to pack them all up that I forgot. My bookshelf before, I just had one bookshelf and it was completely packed full. Well, that's a lie. I had one big bookshelf and two smaller bookshelves, but the big bookshelf was absolutely packed full of books. So I am super excited that I'm able to actually have them spread out instead of stacked and like Tetrised into the bookshelf. So without further ado, let's get right into the bookshelf tour. So before we get into the bookshelves themselves, I just wanted to show these boxes of books from when I unpacked. It took about 20 boxes to get all of these books into. And here are the empty shelves before books. So I had originally planned filming this and then just talking while I was filming, but my tripod is not tall enough, so it was super shaky. So other than this clip, I'm just going to be showing pictures and talking through them. So here's a little overview of my shelves since I can't get it all in one shot. I got these shelves from Amazon and I'll have them linked below. And so let's just get into each shelf. I also wanted to note that these books are all red. I keep my unread books elsewhere. So starting at the shelf all the way to the left at the top, on the left I have kind of some miscellaneous books, and then over to the right I have my young adult contemporary kind of books. Moving down a shelf, we have my adult rom-com slash romance shelf in a rainbow because it looks cool and I would love to do all my shelves in rainbow, but I'm not brave enough, so I decided to just do this one, even though a couple in there, like Taylor Jenkins Reid, aren't necessarily rom-coms. They just fit the best here. Next up, we have a partially empty shelf. I have my moon lamp, which I love, and a jar full of bookmarks, as well as some little boxes that my grandmother left me. I wanted to keep this shelf a little empty because the heating controls are right behind it, so if I have to get back there, then it's easy enough. But I have some historical romance, and then going to the right, going into some historical, and then to the right some more, I have my, what I call my fictional Korea section, which only has 4 books, but still. Next up, we have my nonfiction shelf. All the way to the left, I have some more scientific books, and then in the middle are some more social issue nonfiction, and then all the way to the right, I have my memoirs. On the next shelf down, I have my contemporary graphic novels. So I have The Prince and the Dressmaker, Stargazing, Heartstopper, and Check Please. I highly recommend all of those. They're great. And then I also have a big glass container of paper stars that I made. I used to make those while watching like TV and stuff. So I have literally thousands of them. And I also have a little pile of tchotchkes, I guess, that I would need to find somewhere to put. And then finally, on the bottom shelf of this bookcase, I have my K-pop stuff, specifically my 2PM albums and other 2PM stuff. They're my favorite group. I wanted to put these somewhere else, but that space ended up not working. So for now, they're here. But when I have more books, I'll probably find somewhere else to put them. Moving on over to the next bookcase at the top, I have part of my Brandon Sanderson collection, with spots open for Cytonic and The Skyward Flight, which I still need to finish, as well as some other sci-fi-ish fiction. On the next shelf down, I of course have the rest of my Brandon Sanderson collection. I'm a little bit worried for The Lost Metal to come out because these books fit in this spot perfectly. So something's gonna have to get rearranged and I'm not happy about it. Next up, we have my Green Rider books. This is the whole series plus the Japanese edition of the first book. It's broken up into 2 volumes and the second one's behind it. And no, I don't speak Japanese, but these editions are adorable, so I needed to get them. On the next shelf are a graphic novel for the game Divinity Original Sin 2, as well as my manga collection and some books by Shannon Hale, which are childhood favorites of mine, and some books that I revisit every so often because they are great. On the penultimate shelf of this bookcase, I have my standalone collection. These are all standalones by authors that I haven't read series from. So if I have read a series by an author, I'll try to put the standalone with their other books. And on the last shelf of this bookcase, I have my Avatar The Last Airbender collection. So I have the Kyoshi novels as well as all of the graphic novels that are out currently, I believe, in the big hardcover form, as well as more Paper Stars, which will be showing up again shortly. Okay, we are halfway there, starting at the top of the third bookcase. On the shelf, I just have some fantasy books, some completed series, some not, some sci-fi, and Lord of the Rings, which I need to reread because I read it in middle school and really was not feeling it back then. Next is a shelf with some of my absolute faves. So we have Martha Wells, Samantha Shannon, MXTX, and Tasha Suri. Next up, we have another shelf full of some favorites. So we have The Ninth Reign, The City of Brass, Fireborn, The Goblin Emperor, and my collection of Sharon Shin books. These are some of my favorites of all time. On the next shelf down is my Elise Kova section, which is only getting bigger, and my Lainey Taylor books, which I'm assuming I'm going to have to move soon because I have 5 more Elise Kova books to read before her next one comes out in August. Here we have my shelf of unfinished series that I've only read one book of but haven't read another book by this author, if that isn't confusing, not including the Queens of Renthea series. That series just fit there well. On the last shelf of this bookcase, I have the Vampire Academy series, as well as my Kay O'Neill books, I guess, graphic novels, and the strips I used to make Paper Stars because I needed somewhere to put them. Okay, we are almost there. Starting at the top of the last shelf, I have some YA fantasy duologies, as well as the From Blood and Ash series and Magic Study, and more Paper Stars. This still isn't all of them that I have. Next up, we have a shelf of completed YA fantasy series. I really enjoyed all of these when I read them, but I'm not sure how much I would like them if I reread them, but I also don't want to get rid of them. Okay, the next shelf is more YA. We have the Ash Princess series, which I still really love, as well as my Leigh Bardugo section, including Ninth House, which is not YA, and my Holly Black section. Next, we have the beginning of my Sarah J. Maas section. I still am planning to make a video about my feelings about her. Oh look, more SJM. After those, we have my Marissa Meyer collection, which I'm thinking about getting rid of the Lunar Chronicles. I really enjoyed them when I read them, but I don't think I would ever go back, and I don't know, I just have lukewarm feelings about them now. And here it is, the last shelf on the last bookcase. I have, this is kind of my like childhood nostalgia shelf, so I have my Tamora Pierce books as well as Aragon and To Sleep in a Sea of Stars by Christopher Paolini. I don't feel bad that book is on the bottom shelf all the way in the corner that no one can ever see.
And those are my bookshelves. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!